Once they just start, there should be an end. So I said to her, let us hope for the benefit of all that when she returns, which I hope she does, she won't be a spectator like she was then, but she will be a participator. Participating in what it has to offer to us, the general public, of which she readily agreed. Now we are looking at the train and the cars. There are an upper portion and a lower portion. Where you choose to reside, that is your choice. But if you chose to go to the top and you have cameras, hold them very carefully. It's not because anyone is going to come and demand them from you, but as the train travels, it will be.
Can you remember which one?
We have a few basic rules that we'll normally adhere to. Rule number one, as the train moves, it rocks and rolls. If you have to get up to take your photos or just to look around, I want you to be very careful and hold on to the handrail. Also located downstairs at each car is the washroom. You go down the staircase, at the lower deck, there's a white door. You open that white door, and to the left of that white door is a brown door. That's the washroom. As you go down to use the washroom, please be very careful. Hold on to the handrails and watch your steps. Rule number two. You're not allowed to throw anything from the train. Absolutely nothing. Candies, no monies. Especially toward children, because you know how children are. Once you throw anything, automatically they'll run to get it. But we don't want our children to get it thrown. So we throw absolutely nothing from the train. Rule number three. On this train, we are considered as VIPs. Very important people. As we go along, we're going to see persons on the road. They may be driving in their vehicles, standing around or doing some work, or even the children at school. Let us wave to them. You see here on the island, very friendly bunch. Away from them. So as you go along and you see persons, don't be bashful now. And just all wave to them. Now we are traveling at a speed of 10 miles per hour. And that's what we call Kodak speed or camera speed. Just enough speed for you to look around, take your photos, have your conversation. All in all, just enough speed to accommodate you. I know most of you who have traveled a train before. You have never ever traveled just 10 miles per hour. Never. This is the first. And we're doing that to accommodate you so that you can really enjoy the scenery. And now looking here to our right, our very first village here, the village of Connery. A very long time ago, we used to grow cotton here. This was our cotton growing village. Now as you look around, you can see lots of beautiful homes nestled between those trees. You can really appreciate that it's fast becoming a very beautiful village. Still looking here to our right, where we can see some garbage, etc. That's sort of solid waste. Here is where we take all our garbage, whether it be household, industrial, commercial or otherwise. We take our garbage right there as our solid waste. And now on board we have something very special for you. Something that no other train in this world has. And what we have is that on board we have a live a cappella choir. And those folks that can sing. You're going to enjoy them. From time to time, they'll be on your car to sing for you. For those of you behind, though, whenever the choir is on your car singing, you would not be able to hear me. Now, that's only temporarily. As soon as they leave, you'll resume hearing me. That is because you cannot listen to two things at the same time. So as soon as they leave, you'll resume hearing me. But as you continue still looking there to our right, that large body of water that we're seeing there, that's our fresh water pond. It's from natural rainwater. It's called the Great Hill Pond. It stretches for about 10 acres, including the tree. But as we look around this area too, we can see all of these trees, placing a tent on both sides of the road. You may be wondering if we have snakes on the island, but let me assure you we have no snakes. My mom goes to Canada a very long time ago, so in case you want to go hiking, sightseeing around the area, you have absolutely nothing to worry about. We have no snakes. Now every time we get in this area, you can smell that smell. And we refer to that smell as the smell of money. That is because our farmers, they rear their pigs here. See, here on the island, we eat lots and lots and lots of food. Our farmers have to make sure they supply us with pork in the island, or fresh pork, because we love that very much. On the weekends, we can go to our local market where we can purchase our fresh fruit, our fresh vegetables, and also our fresh pork. Now, this part of the tour takes approximately 2 hours. We'll be covering 18 miles today. 18 miles of lush, beautiful, unspoiled beauty. So make sure you have your cameras all set and prepared so that you don't miss anything. That's what the tour is all about, for you to make sure you capture all of your photos. So have your cameras all poised and ready where you can get all of your beautiful photos as we go along. Now we're going to this area, it's called Canada Estate. And looking here to our right, it's the industrial site of Canada Estate, where we have all of our heavy equipment, our big trucks, our tractors, our bulldozers, our concrete mixers, you name it. So if you're ever here on the island, you need some heavy equipment to rent, here's where you're going to come to rent your heavy equipment, right here at Canada Industrial Estate. And now looking here to our left, our stone quarry. Now when we got here this morning, we realized that we have a protection wall built at Port Zante. A wall that was built to protect the marine and the harbors. Well, here's where we got our stone from. From our very own stone quarry. And these stones are also crushed into smaller particles, which is used for construction purposes, construction of our homes, of our buildings, and also for the paving of our roads. Our very own stone quarry. So as we continue to look to our right along the coastal area, we can see that hillside looking area. Now behind that hillside is another hillside that represents our sister island, Nevis. Nevis is 36 square miles with a population of about 10,000 persons living there. It was also the home of Alexander Hamilton, the first secretary treasurer of the United States. If you look on a 10 US dollar bill, you'll see the face of Alexander Hamilton. He was born right there at our sister island, Nevis. And now coming on board, we have our handsome conductor, Mr. Winston Brown. He normally comes on board to do a head count and to make sure everyone is okay, and have him say good morning to you. Good morning, everyone. Welcome aboard. And welcome to St. Kitts. Thank you very much. That was our handsome conductor, Mr. Winston Brown. Morning. place right here. This is all junkyard. Eventually we'll get into the best spot, but until such time, we place all our content vehicles and our content pads, the place right here. Looking straight ahead, you'll realize we're soon going to encounter our very first level crossing. Level crossings with the island main road meets with the railroad track. Now, whenever we approach those areas, we have the right of way. We have the green light and the traffic has the red light. Remember, I told you we have VIPs, so we wait on no one. The traffic wait on us. The traffic going to and fro. That's Island Main Road. And still looking to our left, you can see this blue and white building. This is the Sky Academy. It's a private school. See some of the children there here? It's a private school. Now these children, in school, it's a regular day school where they come from 8:30 until 3:30. It's a bit on the expensive side, so most of the children that go there, they're children from the expatriates that live here on the island. Now looking straight ahead, we're soon going to encounter a narrow overhead. It is very narrow, this junction, and so we recommend that you keep your hands and your bodies on the inside of the train as we pass under this narrow overhead. Please keep your hands and your bodies on the inside of the train as we pass under this narrow overhead. And we have a beautiful home there on the hill. It is owned by one of our local bankers here on the island. It's a very beautiful home. This is the village of Keys. Not too very big, but here everyone looks out for each other right here in this village of Key. This spring garden in Key, the beautiful floral and vegetable garden here for the community of Key. Thank you. here to our right, filling with the greenwood. That's our horse stable. You can go there, rent a horse, and go horseback riding along the beach. We have some gentle horses who will take care of you and make sure you have a very good time here exploring our beautiful beaches. Still look at the waves, a bit boisterous. Like I said, not recommended for swimming, but if you're into surfing, it is very good. And this area is also called Keys Beach. And here is where normally our leatherback turtles will come up a certain time of the year to lay their eggs. Right here at Keys Beach. We have some of our workers here doing some work. So as we continue to look here to our left, we can see some caves. These are natural bat caves. Natural bat caves here to our left. These are natural bat caves. And now coming on board, we have our choir, as I promised you before. They're here to entertain, so please sit back, relax, and enjoy their singing. Thank you. To everyone. My name is Connie.
Lonia Frencia.
Welcome home to my native land. Beautiful island in the sun. Sanctified love paradise. I'm glad you come before you do.
The highlight of our tour are our four major bridges. I'm going to this area is called the cutting, because in the early days, the slaves had to cut here to form an even ground for the railroad train to run. Now, as we exit these cuttings, we're going to be on our very first major bridge. And that Keyon Bridge. This bridge is 200 feet long, and underneath this bridge is a dried up riverbed that was used as a demarcation line to separate the French from the English. Our very first major bridge, the Keyon Bridge. 200 feet long. Bridge, the Keyon Bridge, 200 feet long. Remember I told you we're going to encounter four? That's the first one. We have three more to encounter before we get to the end of the tour. Now this is the town of Keyon. We have three towns, the major, the largest, the first, is Bastia. That's where your ship is docked. The second, Sandy Point, you will encounter that on the other part of your tour. And now this is our third town, Keyon. Another name for Keyon is the Green Valley. Looking around the area, lush, green, beautiful. You can see how we got its name.